We're going to cross the desk now to James Creedon for today's Media Watch. You're taking a look at a newcomer on the French media landscape that suspiciously looks a lot like our own channel here.
That's right, in particular the name. It's called France Libre 24, or freefrance24.net. And so if you, they have a website, they have Facebook page, Instagram page, and all of that. And sort of over the last 7 months, it's been building a presence online with various news stories. Now, one particular NGO with a focus on the EU, it's an independent NGO whose self-stated mission is to raise awareness on disinformation. They have pooled together with Politico Europe, the news website, to kind of pick apart this particular media and sort of get some sense of who they are and where they come from. Now, a lot of the content online refers to French media of note, such as Le Point, AFP, Le Monde. But if you look a little bit closer, some of the stories are not reported, actually. For example, there was one particular story of an Italian footballer who had been... well, the racist chants directed at him in football stadia. And that seems to have been verified by several media. And here they talk about how he imagined these racist chants and, flipped out on the pitch as a result of that. Another example of a story that was sort of reported or misreported, AFP actually fact-checked this one and, called it out, essentially. It involved a St. Nicholas festival in Italy, also around the festive period, and a case of participants in that particular... it's a sort of a Christmas thing where you have some people dressed up as St. Nicholas and others dressed up as demons. And there was a brouhaha where some members of the crowd were chased by people dressed as demons, right? This was presented by France Libre 24 as a case of migrants who had upset this religious sort of festival being then chased down by participants in it. So again, a case of factual misrepresentation that in this case was called out and fact-checked by AFP. So that's just two examples of stories that were misrepresented by FranceLibre24.net. Now, what they've also uncovered is that the website is linked to a far-right Polish tabloid, rather intriguing and odd. We haven't really understood what their motivation is beyond spreading some kind of disinformation or polarizing the media landscape. But that is the name of that tabloid, which I'm probably not going to do much of a good job of pronouncing. This is their website, Najiski Sekaz, let's just go with that. And it's very much a conservative, I think, veering towards a far-right media with several odd sort of associations with kind of a controversial characters in Poland. Why would they want to set up a website in French, in France, that misrepresents news stories, that sort of picks particularly polarizing topics? Well, unclear, but certainly to create some form of disinformation or to pollute the media landscape.
A little bit of a PSA there, so don't confuse the two.
Right.
France 24 here, very legitimate. I have had people confuse them on Twitter, actually, and send me angry messages before and had to set the record straight.
It's probably the case that posing as a real media outlet, indeed using the name of a more established media, is not an accident. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. More French news that you've been looking at. Mm. Former presidential candidate Ségolène Royal, she's rumored to be on the verge of losing her job.
She's
currently the French ambassador to the polar regions.
That's right. Now, she was presidential candidate back in 2007. When François Hollande, her ex-partner, was president, she was sort of dubbed the vice president. She was the Minister for Ecology at the time. She was one of the architects of France's leading role in having a global position on climate change and whatnot. In any case, when Emmanuel Macron came in as president, she was named the ambassador to the North and South Pole, which did lead people to have joke quite a bit at the time. There were lots of images of penguins and people saying that she had really been just sent off very, very far away. But of course, it is a very important issue with melting polar ice caps and her previous position as ecology minister. She actually was well placed to represent France on the issue of what would happen with climate change and whatnot regarding the polar regions. But she has not apparently turned up at any of the Council of the Arctic meetings, that or meetings that take place, which had led to some admonishment. Furthermore, she has been very critical of the Macron government, in particular in its position on retirement reform. So because she has taken such a public position against Macron on several issues, it appears she did get this letter from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs saying, if you don't stop, you're going to have to leave your position. She has said that she will not stop speaking independently, and many are speculating that she might be thinking of another presidential bid in 2022. There's some people asking that question on social media in any case.
James Creedon, thanks so much for giving us a look at what's trending online and on social media.